Hi guys, so hope you guys are having a great day, and today we are going to make horse treats.
Yes. So back to what I was saying.
These are very, very easy to make. I am a horrible baker and I can make them. I normally set stuff on fire, so that's a lot. I'm really bad. And well, you only need 4 ingredients, which is water. And that's only 1/8 cup of water. Some flour. And you only need 1 cup. Talk about. You need 2 cups of oats. And you need 1/2 cup of molasses. So with the oats, on the instructions, it says oat flour or rolled oats. And well, I found it easiest to grab this thing with a blade. It looks like a blender. It's like a mini blender. I don't know what it is, but look at it. It has this and it has that blade right there. And well, I'll like let you watch me add the oats in it, and it gets really loud, and then I'll plug it in. With 1 cup right now, but I can't add the whole thing in here because our blendy thingy is old and it might break with all this oats in it. So I kind of add 1/2 at a time. So I just plugged this in and I got this locked. This hold this part with my finger and press this button down, and it will get really loud. And so I do this to the rest of the 2 cups of oats, and it just gets it to this powdery thing, and I just take this. And then I just take this and pour it in here. So this is the other 1/2 of that 1 cup. And so I'll do the exact same thing with this, and then I'll just keep, once I get all the 2 cups of oats ground it up, and that's when I'll move on to something else, so. So that was my last bit of the oats. So then I move on to the flour. So the flour is just 1 cup of flour. And so we just stir it until they are nice and mixed before we add the molasses, because the molasses gets really weird and hard to work with. And that's probably the hardest thing, is getting the molasses. See, that's stirred enough. So with molasses, we're just adding 1/2 cup of molasses, and molasses is super, super sticky. Okay, so you want to wash your hands after you work with this, because it's like syrup all over your hands and it stains. So while working with this, make sure you wear like not so great clothes. This all in. So this is currently what my dough looks like, and so I add water just a little bit at a time until like a nice dough forms. You don't need to use all the water, just a little bit here and there, and then you'll So now that I got this mixed, so the next thing is grab a rolling pin and something to lay the rolling pin thing on. We got this paper thing, but you can just use parchment paper. So grab some of this, put it down. So I have my cookie cutters over here. So what I picked was a bone, because Gator's like a dog, and a heart, because I love my boys. Just take this, press it in a part in here. I'll press this one in another part. So I have my cookie sheet ready, so I can just plop them on here. Well, when I cut these out, so I can just plop them on. And so you want to grease your cookie sheet up so they don't stick. And so we'll peel these on off. And if you can't tell, these get very time consuming to cut every little piece out. So I'm just going to make a couple hearts. I'm going to leave the dog thing alone because the hearts are the easiest to make. But you can make literally anything with these. I normally just take and make balls out of them instead of rolling them out all the time. Because I just use them as my everyday treats because they're low in sugar, because they don't have anything that's straight sugar. The molasses is the most sugary thing out of it. They're really tasty. The horses love them. And you can add icing to these. It's fine if you do. I just don't. And so when they feel like they're getting dried out at all, like they're breaking apart as you touch them, you can just put your finger in the water some. And then you just take it, and they just need just slight moisture to them to hold them a little bit better together. So I had just got done making all my treats. There's that tray, and then there's this tray. And I am now going to be setting the oven to 350 degrees. Oops. Oh. Yep. And there we go. And we'll just wait for that to beep and say it's preheated. So the oven just beeped, and now I am going to put these in the oven. And they go in the oven for 10 minutes and 30 seconds. So my timer has just went off.